Thank you very much for inviting me to talk a little bit about which is about daily life kind of things. I think you're absolutely great at making events here. You have a great reputation for that. And you, I was looking forward to winter. I was here in December, a very short visit, and it was not really winter enough. I thought, what is this? I heard you had really severe winters. We don't have that low temperatures. We have high humidity, blasting winds, and we can get really miserable things in the winter. So I was looking for the day that you had yesterday, and I think today. And I'll be happy getting around, and I've got the icons of what you need here for good outdoor life in a city. So I'll talk a little bit about city stuff, and I'll talk about some of the experience from where I come from in Copenhagen. And it'll, a lot of the pictures I show here would be show things that was not there when I was young. So it's all about change and transformation, and you're in a change and transformation situation, and the Winter City themes here is definitely something about that. Here's an old picture I had years ago about where the winter world is, and you can see here that Copenhagen is within the winter world. We have more like the North Sea and the Baltic Sea that makes the climate somewhat different than yours. We are a little further north, but not much, a couple of hundred kilometers, I think. So we have the same kind of situation with winter when there's very short days and long, long, dark nights, and then we are rewarded in the summer as you have are, but they also have this situation to cope with the darkness, the light, and the snow, and all those things generally come there as well. I think great cities for winter are usually also cities that are good in the summer, in the fall, in the spring. So you have to look at city stuff that works all the year round, and then you can celebrate the special seasons, of course. Let's take a little trip to Copenhagen, and that is not the minus 35 centigrades. This is the kind of spring, summerish picture about a situation here in the downtown. And the point is that a lot of the things we do is that we, because of this latitude and the lack of sun, we are absolutely obsessed with getting more sun and sunlight. So getting more of that and expanding that experience to other season is something that has been continuously running in our society. So we started to extend seasons and extend things. This is a sort of a summer day. So the first thing was the extending into the evening. The city was completely empty in the city center and the downtown in evenings. Now the same scene, same evening. It's not a festival. It's just an ordinary Wednesday in the summer. Summer evening, and now one third of all outdoor activities takes place in the evening and night. Unheard of when I was young. Nothing happened at that time. Then also as a symptom, there's many other aspects of this, but as a symptom, outdoor cafe and outdoor sitting, both in public spaces and just at the cafes, we came to love that. After traveling south and finding out that the Italians can do that, we thought it's nice to have it even further up north. We got to love it, and we couldn't get enough of it. And very quickly, cafes found out that a little blanket can help, and you can extend into the cooler summer evenings, and it's good enough for extending into earlier spring and fall. And now a blanket is a Copenhagen standard for any sort of cafe. You'll have that. And it's also a signal that you can get there. Oh, it's good. You can sit there. It's fine. And you can extend it further into the colder parts of the season and enjoy the kind of warm tea or whatever, like these girls there. Also, some of the cafes and restaurants and some of the squares have started to keep the stuff out all year round. So this little square here is a great little gathering place in the summer, but it's now totally open also in the winter. It's not so sustainable with the electric heaters here. I prefer the kind of blankets, definitely, as an idea. But the whole thing is that it has changed the way we think about it. So gradually now you will not think about that it's only in the summer that you can go. First of all, the cafes were not out of doors even in the summer in the old days. I mean, there's very few. But now it's something that we like to have everywhere. It also gathers people sitting on the public benches and all these other places because there's people around, there's more people doing these things. We cannot have enough of it, so why not have this kind of beach situation? We have places with sand also in the city center in the summer. But it's also that this kind of beach furniture suddenly invades the city, that you can have a lean-back situation, and again, with blankets, you can survive a little bit. We've also been working over the years to have better and better conditions for people on foot walking, and when you start having those things, it works really great in the summer. You have more people walking in the summer and that we have in the winter. But on the rainy days, you know, if you're in town, you still go there. The H&M shop sells a few more umbrellas, but you would be there regardless of the climate. Everybody talks about, no, you cannot do this and you cannot do that because of our poor climate. It's raining all the time, and then you have the gray winters and the snow. You cannot do it. It's the same story wherever I go. We promenade and have a great time in the winter as well. It's like you get the habit. So even at heavy snowfall and bad situation like this here, before they can start clearing the snow because it's pouring down constantly, we continue doing what we used to do because that's the habit we've got into. So it's sort of change of culture, you can say. Any city has exhibitions and stuff at different places. We have a lot of those changing public squares. Like this one is a kind of design exhibition of sorts. The same place in the winter, there's another photo exhibition, or the same place another time, a dark winter evening, and you have other exhibitions. So there's always something to go for. I mean, like you do summer, spring, fall, winter. It just changes a little bit on the themes, but it continues to be something where you can take your little walk or you daily commute on foot or on cycle, which a lot of us do. So we also have improved a lot on the cycling. The cycling was low in Copenhagen in the 60s into the 70s when the first oil crisis made a little shock to transportation planning, and we started to do better on cycling, and it's been skyrocketing since. So now 1/3 of the Copenhageners commute to work or education on the daily basis. It's phenomenal high numbers. We are heading for 50%, but that's another story. So you can see kids and older generations on cycle tracks, and we have had a problem of congestion on cycle tracks, and we have really wide cycle tracks. The new ones are 4 meters wide now on some of these main streets in both directions. This picture is another way of having a city. You have faces on the street. If you have more people getting out of the cars, walking or cycling, you have a city where people are present. You see them on the street. It's a completely other feel. And as we got the habit, you continue even on the worst days. Actually, Copenhagen statistics tells us that 70% of us continue in the winter. Of course, not all the winter days are like this. I mean, the snow will be cleared, and that's a key thing, that snow clearance for pedestrians and cyclists has a first priority. Because otherwise, you will get snow, you get the cyclist out on the road, and that's a terrible mess. It's more dangerous and it messes up the whole thing. And you also have to look at where people actually want to go, where the desire line is, not just clearing the sidewalk. Where are the actual desire lines on places? So you have to clear in that way. On top of all these things, of course, we also tend to celebrate the dark seasons and the winters and like that. Not with so majestic programs that you are entering here, and congratulations with your efforts in that direction. Go on with that. But we do celebrate with Christmas and lights and like that. 1 year we had bicycles where you had to pedal to make the lights glow on the Christmas tree on the City Hall Square. Of course, the Tivoli Gardens in downtown also celebrate winter. And this winter, they've had a theme of the Russian theme. You can see we moved a little bit of Moscow over to the Tivoli Gardens. And now we can look at around December at Father Frost, where we used to see Santa Claus, who is a kind of strange person who lives both in Finland and in northern Greenland. They're competing a little bit about where he actually stays. Light, evening, night. I mean, this is a little fountain with a kind of thin sort of water coming over, and these small stars and like that. There's a lot of these small things around in the city that celebrates the darkness, of course. The small, like we saw from Finland on, earlier, these kind of small huts for a Christmas market is something that came like 10 years ago. It's again something that we start doing, which we didn't do before. So we need to have a little bit of heating here, fire, wood or coal heaters. Or you can even sit down with a hot drink and do the same. This is the same space that you saw in the very beginning, just the winter situation. A few times we've done sort of something which would be seen a little crazy at our place, which might be more normal here, as you can actually ski down in the valley, I suppose. But we don't have that hills in Copenhagen, so you can make a ski hill on the City Hall Square for a winter like this one. We have, for a series of years now, had artificially freezing, and I mean, when the winter is not strong enough, the central downtown squares, and this oval, which is a great place in the summer, is now serving as this kind of ice skating ring regularly in winters. It's great to see and great to move around. Others commented on that active activities and active thought of walking, cycling, skating things are things for good for winters because you can get the heat. The downtown shopping mall found out that why not have a fashion show on the ice skating rink when it was there, so they made that. It seems that things you start doing will sparkle other things. People invent other things to do with the things when you have made something. It sort of grows and other gets other ideas and it comes on. Of course, you can make events. We have some here. Here's one and where the COP15 meeting in Copenhagen a few years ago. Of course, there was a big sort of a exhibition sort of thing at the Town Hall Square, and like you do here with the Metropolis and things like that, or another design-oriented exhibition here. So we do some of those things, but I think that the interesting thing about some of the things you might get an inspiration from, I know you'll have to do the Edmontonian way of doing things, and you are far on that trip already, and go for it. But it could be a little bit of inspiration about what you can do with the more daily life situation and bring that in. And then the icing of the cake is all these fantastic things you can do in the winter. And I think I'll leave that with the gloves here, the mittens, and with a little bit of wherever we go, not for winter cities, summer cities, any cities, the first thing people complain about why they cannot do this and that in the city, in their public spaces, is climate. The other one is, it's not our culture. They do it somewhere else, but this is something we don't do. The sort of thing I've learned over many years now of working internationally with these issues is that when you do the right stuff and it starts going, you will change culture. The Copenhageners now think they've had it like that forever. It was not there when I was young. None of it. So good luck with the transformation into being a fantastic winter city. I love your sunshine. You have twice as much sunshine in the winter, if it's not more than we have. So it's a great place to celebrate winter. Have a go.